Hi everybody, this is Oleg, Oleg in Preparedness. Welcome. In today's video, I wanted to talk to you about junk, garbage, things that we don't need, and things that we have a lot of, most of us probably, and at least half of them are just pointless and worthless. As I was looking for some certain documents today in my house, I went through several boxes of stuff where I thought it might be something I was looking for. And it took me a lot of time. And I just thought this, you know, I did move a few times in the past few years, which didn't help matters. You know, I packed everything. Often I bring the case with my last move, I brought everything. And some of my things are still in boxes, still unpacked. Because, you know, I'm so busy working, trying to make a buck, trying to make it happen. And some of my things are still packed. I couldn't remember where my gun was. And today I found it, thank God. I'm glad. And a bunch of other things I came across, a couple of other survival items, items of preparedness. And, you know, I put them in their place now, but there is just a lot of stuff. And I thought, you know, this must be the case for probably most people. Most of us have too much stuff that we really don't need, that gets in the way. And us as preppers, we need to be organized. We need to be organized. We need to know where stuff is. You know, in the event of emergency, you know, you need to know where your stuff is, where your gizmos are in your foods and everything else. You know, of course, as I mentioned before a couple of times, most important things that you might, in a worst case scenario, if you have to leave your place, your house or your apartment and bug out, most important items, I'll repeat it again, you must have it staged either in the garage, by the door, or in the closet by the exit door in your apartment. So in the event that you really, really need to just grab everything that you possibly can fit in your car and go, you won't have time to go through all the crap that you accumulated over the years. You know, before this apartment, I lived in a house that I used to rent. And in that house, I used to do yard sales from time to time. It was good because I would get rid of stuff, stuff that I don't need. Meanwhile, making a couple $100, you know. I don't have the kind of luxury right now. Cannot make yard sale. So I'm just getting rid of stuff by giving it to somebody who might need it. Take it to Goodwill, or if it's just worthless, just throw it away. So, yeah, clean up your junk. Number one, you will clear the space in your house. You will have your preps more organized. Of course, I'm talking about if you're like me, who I want to be more organized, but I'll admit I'm not most organized at the moment, which is not good. But I'm working on it, you know. So if you're in a situation like me, maybe you moved a few times. Maybe you just been too busy with work and you still kept buying some things, some supplies, just piling things, you know, take a day off instead of going doing something, organize your things, throw away things that you don't need. Well, second part of this video, I want to dedicate to a book. You know, when and if crap hits the fan, there may not be lights, there may not be computer and all the information. We are so used to having information at our fingertips on our phones and computers. If there is no electricity, chances are you won't have access to that information. So for moments like that, books come into play. And I would highly recommend anybody and everybody get several books. Books on survival skills, books, especially books on gardening. You know, I know some things about gardening. I can learn more, of course. But most people that live in the city, I'm certain, probably most of them don't have a clue how to garden, you know. So get books on the gardening. I have one book. It's not in my house right now. It's at my mom's house. It's that book is on wild berries and just things, edibles that you can find in the woods. All kinds of roots that you can use for various things. Things that just grow out in the wild, and it covers a wide array of things. So books of that nature. Book I want to talk to you about today is this. I picked up this book a couple of years ago. It's an excellent book. You know, get closer. Outdoor Life. The Ultimate Survival Manual. 333 hacks, skills. I would highly recommend this book or any book like that. I'm not promoting this particular book, although this book deserves a look. It has everything. It has, for example, look, I just opened the page. How to treat a snake bite, you know, or how to full color pictures, how to treat scorpion bite, how to survive tsunami, how to survive earthquake, how to survive fires. This book truly has solution, I think, to, I'll say, 99.9% of things that can occur. I'll never say 100% because, you know, there's always something unexpected. I picked up this book at Fred Meyer's. It's a Kroger store. They have book section in their stores. I'm almost sure you can find it online, or you can find it, you know, in Barnes & Noble. An excellent book, just full of explanations and diagrams and colorful pictures and ideas, how to find food, how to survive snow, how to survive flood. Pretty much anything you can think of, you will find answers in this book. So get this book or get similar books, get any books. You know, my top books is one of these, for example. Another kind of a book that you'd want is, as I mentioned before, on different edibles, things that grow in the wild, in the woods, in the prairie. Get an atlas. You know, atlases and maps, they are slowly disappearing because, you know, no one's using them. You know, get a topo map, if you can, of your area where you're at. So maps, books with surviving skills, books with how you, to get food just out of woods. And also another excellent book, it's also at my mom's house. I'll make a video on that some other time. It's on how to make your own medicine out of herbs. You know, back in the day, 100, 200 years ago, there was no medicine. There was no Tylenol or ibuprofen and all the prescription drugs. People took care of themselves by making medicine out of herbs, and it worked. You know, herb medicine, obviously, it's not strong as chemicals, so it doesn't work as fast. But it still works. Just need to do it more of it and more often. So if there is no medicine and you have health issue and there is no electricity, if you have one of those books, bingo. You are saved, you know. So, yeah, get in the books. So I'm going to conclude this video, you know. Those of you who have a lot of trash like I do, clear it out, and it will make your place more organized. You'll have more space for your preps, for one, and you'll be able to organize your preps better. And also, for those of you who don't have any books as a backup material, get some. It's not a lot of money. If you never have to use it, all the better. But if that time comes, you'll be so glad you did picked up the book. Okay, thank you everybody for watching. Please like and share. Please subscribe if you haven't. It'll help my channel grow. Leave a comment if you have any other ideas. And I'll see you in the next upload. Bye-bye.